Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Path of Exile. Here we are next to Nessa, and we're going to turn in the quest for killing the brute.
Merveil dwells in the caves beyond the wrecks, at the head of Siren's Cove. Leave her be, and we can only hope that she continues to return the favor.
Oh, I guess we're just getting a new quest to take on Merveil.
That graveyard of broken ships? Merveil's welcome, Matt. And those poor, haunting souls among the wrecks? There's no happily ever after when you caught one of Merveil's brood.
Ooh, sounds like a risky mission. Anybody else have something to say? Elrion has something to say here.
Ah, God has delivered you to me, and as always, his timing is divine. I've just put the finishing touches on a few baubles. Dripping with faith they are, brimful. Have a wee look and let me know what you think.
Oh, he's got some new stuff, eh? Let's take a look. Oh, these are all just those things. They're talking about baubles then. I'm not quite sure on that one. Oh well, let's head on here. So I guess we're heading to the ship graveyard? Is that, where is that located there? Oh shoot, how do I get to this one? That's what I wanted to do. Is it right there? I suppose. Yeah, looks like it. Ship graveyard. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, this is where we were. Duh. We were over here in the ship graveyard. Sorry, guys. So let's go see what's going on in the ship graveyard. I think there's a cave, too, now that I remember. So let's take a look around. I think we'll have to find it again, because it looks like the map's reset. Well, on my way when I was looking for the cave, I found this deadly remote gulch. And it says increased monster damage and increased quantity of items found in this area. So let's check this out. I know this is a little bit off track from what we would do, but it seems like an area I should explore since it's blue. And looks like we got some fire dogs and some big giants. I don't know if they're giants, but they're definitely taller than regular people, it looks like. Holy smokes, this thing is tough. It's been eating all my arrows, just eating them. Sharp back the crazed. He's fractured, extra life rendered as damaged. Oh, and he just split into a whole bunch of dudes. That's not good. Take those guys out. There we go. Alright, soldier helmet. We'll pick that up. An orb of chance. Upgrades a normal item to a random rarity. Ooh, that's exciting. I wonder what the chance is to get it to like a unique item or a legendary or something like that. That sounds really neat. Probably be hanging on to that for a while until I get something really cool. Some weird serpentine constructs here. These guys are strange. They're like robot snakes, I suppose. Very interesting. Superior longbow. Pick that up. Just in case. Never know when you need a good superior longbow to try and change into something awesome. It's got some weird things flying around. There's some black energy. It might be related to those breaches. I remember seeing a lot of that kind of stuff near the breaches. So I wonder if there's other breaches in this area, or that's what this area is. Just a strange kind of twisted energy land. Cool enemies in here though. I'm trying to use the ballista a little bit, see if it's worth it. Ooh, shark tooth claw. Oh yeah, I've already seen those. Never mind. Oh, we've got two good green slots though. We'll take that. It's a weapon. We could upgrade it to something cool. That's the beauty of this game, is even the white items you can re-roll into awesome stuff. Scroll of Wisdom. Always welcome to Scrolls of Wisdom. I seem to burn through those really crazy. This seems to be a dead end. Oh, no, never mind. I was mistaken. Jeez, there's so many of these exploding dogs, though. 2-point arrow quiver. Have I seen that yet? Increased accuracy? Yeah, I think I've seen that already. I could take it and roll it into something, but I'm just gonna wait for it to quiver, I think. There is a lot of these guys. I'm cool with that, though. Some more loot for me. Ooh, what's going on with... Whoa, we got a special guy here, too. Okay. Hold the phone. Well, a little bit more careful here. I'm gonna use my decoy in this situation. That's kind of cool. I don't know if he took many shots or anything, but it seemed to be awesome. I don't actually know if this teleport does damage to things. Yeah, it looks like it does damage. I don't know if that means the decoy does damage, but it does damage though. take this totem down. Oh no, never mind. He's way too strong. Let's just put our ballista down, our decoy, fire off some fire arrows. And there we go. Got him down. Wasn't too bad. Let's see. Oh, there we go. Serrated
that
arrow.
That would only slow me down.
Oh, slow you down? No way. Let's just drop that, I suppose. Take that. I'm gonna ID that right away. Oh yeah, that looks great. Way better than what I'm using. Just chuck that one on the ground. And, I'll take the circlet. Because in Diablo 2, circlets could always be amazing. Take the shark tooth claw. And I don't really care about anything else. Could take the longbow, but eh. I'm rolling with what I got. Oh, do we got some story over here? Alright, story time. Hold on. Adziri promises us eternal life. The only eternity we shall have is the memories of the barbarians that shall plant their crops on our graves. That's pretty dark. I don't know where that came from. I wonder if there's some kind of war going on between, like, two different cultures in this area or something like that. Very, very strange. Is that the whole area? Like, is it just one long gulch, I suppose is what it is? Take the scroll. It still seems like there's that dark energy. I'm just gonna scroll the map up. Did I miss something here? No, it doesn't look like it. Alright, well, back to what we were normally doing. And I'll see you guys when I find the cave or anything else interesting. Alright guys, here's the ship graveyard cave, so let's head in here, because I think this is where we need to go. Find the All Flame. Alright, that's our new mission, so let's head on here. On the way here, I got my gem stall level up, but I need to be level 16 in order to level them up. Fortunately, I just hit it. So, let's go ahead and level all those abilities up. And I'll spend the point later on. Let's see. Got some more of these shield crabs. I don't really like these things. They take quite a while to just whack down with a whole bunch of arrows because you have to knock their shells off. Well, let's see, we found our strong box over here. Which is, is that part of the things that I have going on? Yeah, it is. So this is the benefit of my legacy stones. We gotta take these things on. These guys explode when they die. Watch out. And it wasn't too hard. Oh, we had a couple more. That was a problem. There we go. Armor scrap. And that's about all worth interest right there. Let's see, there are more of these things. Let's just throw down our ballista. This quiver's making our damage go a little bit out of control over here. Everything we hit just takes a whole bunch of fire damage. It's kind of great. Just barrels. Always gotta look and just check. You never know where a good loot's gonna be. You least expect it. And you always miss what you don't check, right? You miss every shot you don't take. That's how the saying goes. Let's see, more ships down. Ooh, a lot of ghosts and stuff in here. Ghosty pirates. Now this is our talisman guy that we gotta fight. They always got these weird fiery skulls around them, it seems like. Can't teleport away here, drop my decoy. Pour some arrows over this guy here. I can't tell if those little skulls are just like part of something or like part of the item, because they hang out for a little bit, but then they just go away. So it's like they're not enemies. That's kind of interesting, increased fire damage, but we don't really care about that. I mean, we have a bunch of fire damage, but not enough to really warrant losing the dexterity bonus from our current amulet, which is 20, which is, I think, is awesome. I think that's a great amount of dexterity for a low-level rare amulet. We got League Stone. Ample Ambush League Stone. Taking in a strong box and an additional strong box. Double strong boxes. Yeah, we need to get to level 30 so we can use 3 League Stones. A Slave Girl, and a Strangled Charm. Ice Nova, cold damage, and enemies are slowed. Alright, well, let's go ahead and teleport away over here. Get dropped. Scrubbity-dub. Alright, we got a Quest Girl over there, but let's take a little look around first. You never want to miss out on some good loots or anything. Cone Helmet. I don't know if I have room for that even.
Only slow
nope,
me down.
Sure don't. Alright, let's check down here and talk to the slave girl. Oh, I guess she was dead. Sorry, slave girl. The monstrosity of the All-Flame, it had a description. Distilled from naked ambition and unfettered obsession, the All-Flame emanates a silvern warmth like no other and engulfs those moths fool enough to embrace it. Wow. Sounds pretty crazy. It's like a little green lantern, it looks like. Alright, back to the ship graveyard, and now I'm gonna find Merveil, so I'll see you in a second. Alright, here we are at Fairgraves, not Merveil, sorry about that. What's up, Fairgraves?
My All-Flame. My blessed, damned All-Flame. Oh, you want your moment in the firelight now, do you? Unfortunately, necessity is what it is, and for the All-Flame to give life, it must first be kindled with life. And since suitable kindling is in short supply around these parts, I have little option but to make do with what I have. Namely, you.
Uh-oh, he got... Oh.
Please understand that as a gentleman of honor, it pains me greatly to do this. Hard times call for hard hearts. I'm sure, were the circumstances reversed, you'd do precisely the same.
Probably, the only difference is I wouldn't screw it up and get wasted. So, there you go, Fairgraves. I want to call him Allgraves because I'm thinking of All-Flame and him at the same time. But he doesn't really like fire arrows too much. But I can't hit him with him, so it's a fair game. He seems to just like throw out his weapon all the time. There we go.
Right. You were a good man in a bad situation, Fairgraves.
Yep, good man in a bad situation. Exactly. Alright, well, let's head back to Lion's Eye Watch. Let's head back there. And we'll talk to whoever is interested in turning the quest in for us, honestly. It doesn't really tell. Oh, Vestal. Alright, let's talk to Vestal. What's up, Vestal?
Fairgraves was a good man. A fine explorer. He opened the door to many a new world. For better or for worse. Usually for worse when it came to the natives. There's some peace in the knowledge that he now rests where he should. Let's not speak of Fairgraves again, shall we? He was an inspiration to many. It would be a shame to spoil a good hero.
Yeah, let's not spoil it. Passive skill point. Alright. I just have nowhere to put it. Alright, well let's take a look here. I'm gonna take a second and take care of this mess. Alright, took care of my inventory problem, and also when I was in the ship graveyard, I stumbled across this cool spell called Animate Weapon. And it animates a melee weapon to fight by my side, so I'm kind of interested in trying to play with that, but I don't have any green slots right now, so when I get some green slots, we'll try playing with that, because that sounds like a lot of fun.
Not right now.
I accidentally clicked on Merveil instead of my Fairgraves award. I did it again. So we're going to listen to that, and also talk to the rest of the NPCs here and see what's going on.
Siren's Cove belongs to Merveil. Those butchering buccaneers sailed off that way. The ones that plundered my poor Mary Gold. It would be poetic justice if they'd stopped off for a sing-along with Merveil's lovely daughters on their way home. Piety's raised Chevron's barricade. Not that I was likely to ever make the trip inland, but it was nice to have the dream. Hang on a moment. Got a stray thought seeking safe harbor. Piety's one to watch her own back, so she'd never cut off an escape route from possible trouble inland. The cunning witch must be able to lower that barricade from the other side, somehow. Legend has it that Chevron of Umbra made that thaumaturgical barrier at Prisoner's Gate, a precaution against Karui raiders wanting a piece of the Inner Empire.
Oh man. Lots of details from Vestal there. He's a pretty sharp guy. He knows a lot about things.
Welcome.
Don't we have any prophecies yet?
Nope.
Thanks. And let's listen to what Tarkley has to say about Merveil.
If you have to quench your curiosity about Merveil, go look at the corsairs that haunt the grave of ships. Like any mother, Merveil's got hungry mouths to feed.
Ah, so he is related to those ghost pirates, it seems like.
Piety's cut us off from the interior. That's bloody troubling news.
Another day in damnation.
Well, it seems like everything and everybody has to say, so let's head back to it. Looks like we gotta go from the ship graveyard to Merveil's cavern somehow. And I remember on my map, let's see, there was a spot I thought I could take. Wasn't that one? Maybe it's north. Anyways, I'll see you guys in a second when I find it. I stumbled upon this cavern of wrath way down at the bottom here, and that sounds like it could be Merveil's cavern, so let's check it out. It's at least a new area, I think. If I've been here before, I'll cut it out. Oh no, this is definitely a new area. Alright, well, the thing says to go talk to Nessa, so let's do that before anything else. So maybe she has something to advise us on about this cavern of Merveil's here. Let's see. Hey there, Nessa.
If you must take your chances with the siren, then have this. It may be of some help, but please, know that you don't have to do this. Tarkley and I are getting used to having you around.
Don't worry, I'm still gonna stay around. I ain't going down from some silly siren. Rain of arrows? Lightning arrow? Ooh, damages nearby enemies, a lightning strike. Well, we're definitely gonna take lightning arrow, because that sounds awesome. Does Tarkley have something to say about the siren?
Still alive, are we?
Nope. Alright, well, let's head back. So we got... we got more Merveil's caverns to do. And supposedly there's gonna be a siren for us to fight. We got a waypoint here. That's good. I guess I could just use that instead of using a portal. Wow, I didn't expect that. Looks like Merveil's trying to siren us a little bit with her song.
Welcome, husband. We knew in our hearts that you would find us. Come, Dereso. Ambrosia and Amarissa must meet their father. Come, my love. Return to your family.
Wow, that is a creepy message written on somebody's skin stretched out on like a canvas type thing. Jeez. This is a twisted cavern. Maybe they were right to warn me about this place. This is evil as hell already. And it's so dark in here. Is there gonna be creepy crawlies or have they all been slain already? I'm hearing like slithering sounds and another little creepy noises. Oh, got some buccaneers here. Take those guys out. Are the leak stone active? I sure hope I have a leak stone active. Legacy? Oh shoot, I don't have any stones active. Well, dang it. Next time I get to a door entrance, I'll have to put some stones on. Sorry guys, I thought I still had one more charge. Well, let's see, greater life flask. Let's take that, probably upgrade that, see if we can turn it into something cool. Should we take the Aztec from? You never know. I'm not really sure what the next tier of bows I'm going to be looking for is, because I've kind of been waiting for the next tier so I can use an item. That was a horrible sound from this, I'm definitely going to kill those pretty quick. Waiting for the next tier of bow to find like a white version of it so I can let's see. Let's more singing sirens. I need to kill this thing as fast as possible. It's the most horrible noise I've ever heard. Jesus. No. Less of that, please. Whatever sound you guys want to make, please make less of it. There we go. So a couple of these things. What was that thing I picked up there? Talisman. Physical damage, alright, that's what I'm talking about. Alright, I'll rock that one. I don't really know what it means when an item is corrupted, though. I wonder if that has an effect on my character in any way. Or if it's just like, maybe the item works better in certain areas, or less effective in other areas, or needs to be purified. I don't really know. Or greater life flasks. Definitely a fan of those. Some chests here. Some wisdom. Can't complain. Nothing too challenging so far. I figured this was just gonna be like a little side path, but maybe this is the main path, or maybe this place is huge, I have no idea. Seems like a lot of maps in this game are pretty sprawling, which I don't mind, just means more slaying monsters, which is more experience, more fun, some good times all around. I'm really enjoying my build right now, too. Just fire and arrows. blasting things. Oh, we've got a strong box here. Definitely gonna take a look at that. Ice Nova monsters. Alright, let's just wipe them out. Nope, not too bad. Ooh, chain gloves, jade hatchet, rusted hatchet. See, this is the kind of stuff I want to use that animate weapon on. I don't really see anything else worth checking out there, though. Battered foil? Nah, it's a sword. I'm just gonna animate the good stuff, since I don't really plan on using any melee weapons that aren't weapons. You know, I think I am right now. You know, I haven't really punched anything in a while. Did I punch some things? Let's try punching some things. Oh, that's such a horrendous noise. Is it just sometimes when they die? Because I haven't seen one do it since that first time. Oh, I think you got away, didn't you? Looks like there's some... Oh, it's a bridge. No thanks, Merveil. I think I'm just gonna punch you. I might have to switch back to the bow for Merveil. I don't know how strong I am right now with this weapon. Did we miss some stuff? Okay, it looks like there's an area there I might have missed, but it looks like this is the way to go. So let's activate some League Stones. See what we got here. Silver coins, strong box. Well, definitely you want this one for super awesome strong box times. And yeah, Nemesis mod. Let's do that one. Just turn it up a whole bunch. See what happens. Cavern of Anger. Alright, let's see what happens then. Wow. Kind of very quiet singing from Merveil, but I'm hearing a lot of like little voices in the background now. And I think my character was just hallucinating a little bit there for a second. I thought I saw like a spirit just walking into something. It was kind of messing with my head there. The audio in this game is awesome. Alright, let's fire off some ice enchanted punches here. Just punch everything out. Even though I haven't been using this ability, it's still been leveling up because I have it equipped. Which is pretty awesome. But I can only use it when I'm on my fist arm, of course. Bringer of Fragility. I think I said that right. I don't really know for sure, though. Don't pull me on. Bam. Broadsword, another thing to do. Well, it's a composite bow. That sounds exactly like what I was looking for. Bam. It's kind of funny, because in my Dark Souls 3 Let's Play right now, I'm actually looking forward to getting the composite bow in that Let's Play as well pretty soon. Let's see, I'm actually going to ditch the short bow and just pick this up. It also has 3 slots, which is just awesome. I'm definitely going to be messing around with that thing. Seems like a couple of these singing sirens were named Merveil's daughters. These things actually resist cold. The noise is just horrible. So let's switch back to the bow since we got some fire damage on this thing. Let's see, this one does 8 to 29, 12 to 26. So if we enchant that, turn it into something, maybe I'll use that random rarity one, the Orb of Chance, on it, and see if I can get something really cool. Curse spawn across. Wipe these guys out. I don't think using fire on these guys is really effective. Maybe this ability just does a lot of damage right now. Jade Amulet. Yeah, we'll take that. Could be something cool. Another strong box. I think we're supposed to have multiple strong boxes with this current thing I have going on. Jonah and Chain. This guy just resists elemental damage altogether. Good thing I'm trying to build physical damage. Alright, well, that got us a whole bunch of stuff. I didn't expect all that. Sapphire Ring? I don't really know what a lot of this stuff is, but I don't think I'm interested in a whole bunch of it.
That would only slow me down.
Yeah, I'm not even gonna bother with any of that. Can I carry this weapon? Yeah, we'll take that to animate it when we get the setup for it. Be a lot of fun. See, there's like little spirits that just keep walking by. I don't really know what's up with that. So we still have, well, that wasn't a door. It just looks like a portal on the map. I guess the portals are actually red, though. Pay attention to that. Let's see. Looks like we got something special over there. Is that a mermaid? No, it's just a singing siren. Sirens are definitely not what I expected from what sirens look like. usually imagine some kind of like mermaid or winged creature or flying creature or something. Sea creature of some kind, but these things are just like weird tentacle monsters that make a bunch of noise. Well, let's look at a couple of these guys. These guys might be unique to this map, just the result of my league stones. Another level up, nice. That's good, because we're about to level up our ability soon, too. Inventory's full again, so I can't pick those up. There's another strong box. And this one's got its pin here, so we're actually gonna... we're gonna heal ourselves and get the heck out of there, first of all. Man, these things are just so vicious. There we go. And down. And a couple more scrolls of wisdom. We got a rare shot bow. It's worth dropping, it's one of these things for... that, just to see if it's any good. Let's find out right away. 10 to 26, increased physical damage, attack speed. But the sockets aren't as good, and I can't do that with it, so we're gonna drop that. Let's check out this oiled vest, because these things usually can have a lot of dexterity. Yeah, that's pretty good. I'd say we'll swap that out. Put that back on that, drop that, because we don't care anymore. I'll take the bastard sword instead of the broadsword there, though. Sounds like a good trade. And once, you know, I really should take a minute and just do the switch so I can use anime weapons. I'm really excited for it, but I think I'll just save it for next episode. Something to look forward to. Oh my gosh, these guys. So many sirens. Alright, well, looks like we got something mega special up there. Maybe not, though. Maybe it's just weird ores I haven't seen yet. That's what it appears to be. We got one kind of special guy over here, though. Let's try and see what his name is, if I can get rid of these guys. Ambrosia, daughter of Merveil. Oh, this is one of those. Ooh, Merveil didn't like that very much. Ooh, sorry about that, Merveil. The music just went dead. Oh my god, there's like scary whispering going on. It's like freaking me out now. I'm just like changing my equipment, like, sorry, I'm looting your daughter's corpse. Maximum life. It seems worth. Is that a green slot? Oh yeah, it's a green slot. Bam, anime weapon. Alright, so we have to identify these things. Let's do the big old sword here first. Alright, animate some weapon. So, how do I use it? E? Does it have to be on the ground? Yeah, there we go. We animated a jade club. Now it'll bonk things for us. This is awesome. Sorry, Merveil, if you're gonna be taunting me like that to go that way, I'm actually gonna head this way because I missed a couple things over here. So I'll see you back on the other side in a sec. And here we are back at this guy. So let's fight this guy, level up our gem. We're fighting Pit Moil here. And he's making a bunch of noise. Orb of Regret. Oh, okay, you can refund your points, that's pretty cool. These things only... oh, they only last a certain amount of time, too. Okay. Interesting. So can we... oops, sorry, I keep hitting the wrong button there. Core level 8. Okay, let's actually carry that with us till we run into some opponents here. Now we're gonna drop it and animate it. And see if we can turn that into something. Lesser multiple projectiles. Okay, we level up our support gem. That's awesome. And I guess that's all I wanted to do over there was fight that guy. I guess I should have just taken him on when I saw him. I almost saw the deal with like the sparklies on the ground. It's like Merveil's treasure maybe or something like that. It's definitely very, very sparkly. Oh, Merveil's lair. Here we go. League stones are still going strong. Alright, let's go in. Ooh, lots of treasure in here. And intense music. Oh my gosh, Merveil the Siren. Alright, well let's go ahead and drop our axe here. Throw up an animate weapon on it. Yeah. Looks like she's got animated weapons too. She shoots ice fish? Am I seeing that right? Look at that axe go. Look at it right there. It's just whopping on her. Awesome. It's like whap whap. It's like having a secondary melee character. Let's put a decoy out. There we go. Just wiping her out here. She doesn't stand no chance. Fire off some multi-shots. I don't even have to know where she is. Just fire them off. Oh, all the treasure was like bone piles and illusions. Oh my gosh, she's got like a face suit. Alright, well I don't know what happened to my melee weapon. I don't think I have another one to replace it. So I'm just gonna fire off a bunch of the same strategy as before. Looks like these big geysers are coming into the ground. Just one of her spells that it feels like. She's got a lot of them. Holy, she's going nuts. That little animation when they scream. I wondered why she looked like a woman. This is love's true face right here. Ugh. Looks like there's some actual treasure up there, unless there's still even more illusion. Twisted, huh? Alright, I'm taking down the star.
Your love for a man. That's what did this to you, Merveil.
Your love for a man. That looks pretty
that
good.
That would only slow me down.
Full inventory here. Alright, animate weapon can level up. What does that get us to? Does it allow it to use on more higher level things now? Level 11, awesome. Damp diary.
Duresso gave me the gem, kissed me, promised that he would be by my side forever. I sang for him. I sang for Oriath with his gem at my throat. Kalisa's gem. Kalisa's voice. I sang in her echo, performing arias that had once made the Empire weep. I listened to Kalisa's lullabies in my dreams. I gave myself to her music, mind and body. Duresso left me for San with a promise to free me from Kalisa. I begged him not to go, tried to show him the wonder of my transformation, the beautiful daughters he would soon meet. He couldn't see. None of them could see. I fled from their hatred. When Duresso returns, I will cast his cure away. I will teach him what true love is.
Oh my gosh, Merveil, super twisted. Alright guys, well we're gonna call it an episode there for the day, because it looks like we're about to interact too, and this episode's been going for a while, so that's all for today. I hope you're enjoying the Ranger playthrough so far. I certainly am. And we'll have some more anime weapon fun next time. So thanks for watching, and bye for now.